Successful organizations today thrive on happy employees and strong company cultures. And the science of collecting data that gives us insight into employee engagement and the health of an organization's culture is what we call people analytics. Through the data we collect, we can understand the employee experience and pinpoint what drives performance. And today, HR leaders rely more on employee data than ever before, and they are hiring more analysts. But which metrics should organizations focus on, and how can analysts help improve company culture? Let's explore people analytics and the key measures companies use to help them create a motivated and skilled workforce today on Art Science. Hey there, I'm Kevin Hartman, Associate Professor at the University of Notre Dame and founder of the Art Science Analytics Institute, where our mission is to make you a better data analyst. It is not an overstatement to say that people analytics has revolutionized human resources. It measures important aspects of the employee experience, enables data-driven decisions, and provides clear insights for targeted actions that improve satisfaction and performance. People analytics can help organizations predict challenges in their workforce before they happen, giving companies the chance to tackle issues like high turnover or burnout before they become the kind of problems that have been doom for some companies in the past. For example, changes in engagement scores may indicate problems with management or workload distribution or any number of issues in the workplace. But by catching these indicators early on, organizations can dig into problems, prevent them from affecting teams, and work to retain their top talent. This is the power of proactive people management through people analytics. Importantly, people analytics allows companies to understand their employees' unique dynamics and drivers for workplace satisfaction, which allows them to move beyond general assumptions to create a more accurate understanding of what matters most to their employees. Let's take a closer look now at some foundational metrics in people analytics. Those metrics that provide truly valuable insights into employee sentiment, behavior, and loyalty. The Employee Net Promoter Score, eNPS, is a powerful tool for gauging employee sentiment based on the concept of a consumer-facing NPS score designed in 2003 by Fred Reichheld of the consulting firm Bain & Company. This metric asks a simple question on a scale of 0 to 10. How likely are you to recommend this company as a place to work? Followed by the all-important question of why did you score it the way you did? Respondents are categorized as promoters, where they responded with a 9 or a 10, passives, where they gave a score of 7 or 8, or detractors, where they scored 6 or below. Pulse surveys are typically used to collect employee feedback triggered by events like training completions or performance reviews. NPS can also be used broadly across the entire company at planned times as well. And eNPS becomes a very important measure with regards to employee loyalty and enthusiasm. A high score suggests positivity, while a low score could mean there might be issues there. Calculating eNPS is very simple. It's basically the percent of employees who scored as promoters, 9 or 10, and then subtracting the percent of employees who scored as detractors, 6 or below. And the net of those two scores becomes your eNPS score. When you're tracking single employees because of some triggered event, you just want to know where they landed in the three categories. But if the score or the survey is conducted across the entire workforce at points in time, you're looking for that net eNPS score and how it is changing over time relative to events or happenings in the marketplace. And one particularly useful way of using eNPS is tracking that number by department, job role, or length of employment. Basically, by tracking through a cohort of your employees, that allows you to pinpoint areas that may require further attention and detail. Successful organizations go deeper than just tracking basic surface turnover and retention rates to understand their workforce deeply. These lagging indicators really only show us issues that have already affected team morale, productivity, and culture. So forward-thinking companies pay attention to leading indicators like absenteeism and attendance and engagement to catch problems early on and address them before they become full-blown challenges. Advanced organizations utilizing people analytics in this way will use team-based metrics like attendance, absenteeism, engagement, to measure employee well-being and loyalty. These act as real-time gauges for potential issues, and by monitoring patterns and addressing those challenges, companies can prevent burnout, they can support their employees, and they can prevent high turnover rates, which are costly in terms of money, but also costly in terms of the impact on culture. Using these data ethically can create a culture of trust instead of surveillance, and that allows for tailored retention strategies based on insights from the data we've collected, and allowing then the company to proactively address these issues. Productivity is no longer solely measured by output. Modern people analytics organizations consider a wider range of factors such as data to understand employee efficiency, work quality, and the broader impact on the team and the organization. This includes tracking goals, project outcomes, and evaluations from peers and managers. This data is valuable for measuring employee motivation, engagement, and support. A decrease in performance may indicate burnout, unclear expectations, or a mismatch between skills and role. And by analyzing performance data, over time, companies can uncover patterns that may not be visible in traditional reviews and correlate those data between performance, engagement, turnover, and absenteeism to reveal important trends. For example, do top performers tend to stay with the company longer? Are dips in productivity linked to changes in policy or workload? These insights allow companies to make necessary adjustments and support employee growth. Time to hire is a key metric that tracks the days between when a job opening is posted and when a candidate is hired. It shows recruitment efficiency and how quickly roles can be filled to meet business needs. A shorter time to hire suggests an effective and efficient process, while longer times may signal areas for improvement or difficulty in finding qualified candidates. Time to hire is not only a measure of efficiency, it can also help gauge the organization's attractiveness to potential employees. When it's taking companies a long time to fill their job openings, this can indicate larger issues such as overly competitive roles or weak employer brand, or just a mismatch between what the company is offering and what the market is demanding. When used correctly, this measure is used at a department level, a team level, and a job or role level so that it can the company can set effective goals for hiring and manage expectations through the process. Tracking time to hire can help organizations streamline their recruitment process, improve their employer brand, and create more attractive candidate experiences. Each indicator we've mentioned offers a glimpse into an employee's daily life and experience, but understanding them in relation to each other is crucial. This gives the organization the complete picture and allows them to start connecting dots. For example, combining eNPS results with productivity data can show if the sentiment that employees are feeling is pulling through to the actual workplace experience. Thanks to AI and machine learning, HR can now use data to predict flight risks and address potential issues like workload dissatisfaction or career limitation before employees hand in their notices. This leads to improved employee experiences and higher retention rates. However, the power of people analytics lies not just in the predictive accuracy of their models and the depth of data, but in the transparency of the data collection and the way the company is using those data. To drive genuine engagement, companies must approach data collection openly, they must obtain informed consent from employees, and they must clearly communicate how their information will be used to improve the workplace. This trust-centered approach fosters a culture of respect where employees feel valued rather than surveilled, and ultimately helps lead to a happier, more engaged workforce. Data is important, but it is not enough to drive engagement and retention. People analytics must capture the nuances of the employee experience and analyze with empathy and intention to shape a workplace where employees feel heard, understood, and empowered. To put the ideas that we've discussed tonight into practice as a people analyst, you can follow these steps. Go beyond simply providing data and strive to be a strategic partner. Use data storytelling to explain complex metrics that are collected through people analytics in a clear and impactful way, and help leaders understand the reasoning behind the numbers. By presenting insights that resonate, you can make the data more accessible and motivate leadership to take action. Use your data to collaborate with HR and design solutions for identifying areas of improvement, such as stress among new hires or training gaps. Pinpoint targeted interventions from your insights, like wellness programs or mentoring opportunities. Be proactive in suggesting initiatives that address employee needs indicated by the data. Take a hypothesis-driven and iterative approach to people analytics, regularly revisiting key metrics and questioning your assumptions. Keep in mind that data trends and employee needs change over time, so your analysis should evolve as well. Reassess and adjust your insights to stay relevant and responsive to the organization's dynamics. People analytics can transform workplaces, providing leaders with clear insights into success and failures. As analysts, we are responsible for turning these insights into actions that prioritize both employees and the business's profitability. Thanks so much for watching. If you haven't already, take a moment and subscribe to this channel, like this video, and share it with anyone who you think is interested in data analytics. Every single week, we are bringing new, exciting, and important videos on data analytics to this channel, and we would love to have you there for the journey. Also, be sure to check out the links in the description for additional Art+Science resources, and sign up for our newsletter to get exclusive tips, course updates, and more directly in your inbox. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.